Welcome everyone and Happy New Year. And this is a meeting for prospective patients. And I want to thank all of you for taking time on Saturday to join me. And before I open the lines for questions, I'd just like to go over some information briefly. I'm going to share my screen. I'm really excited. Every year we put on our vision event. And this year, I'd like to play some of the intro music for you.
We can talk that matters, only on KFNX.
And this is music from the opera Turandot. And the reason why I like it, it's Vincere, Vincere, which means I will conquer, I will conquer. And that is the theme of this year's vision event. I will conquer, I will conquer, and I'd like to help all of you conquer your vision loss. Now let's wait till the music finishes the intro.
Author of four best-selling books. Healthy Vision is dedicated to bringing you the latest information for a lifetime of healthy sight and to help you conquer your eye problems. And now, your host, Dr. Edward Kondrat.
Well, that for 22 years, I had a radio show on KFNX in out of Phoenix, Arizona, and it was all about healthy vision. And this year, we have an amazing lineup of speakers. We have eight top alternative doctors are going to be sharing valuable information with you. And also, you have an amazing set of bonuses here, bonuses of over $116 value, different audiobooks, textbooks, and information. And here's a lineup of some of the speakers. Oh, and incidentally, you can go to this landing page, go to Vision Event 2023. That's Vision Event 2023. And it'll take you to this URL. Dr. Jacob Lieberman, who's a well-known authority on color therapy, will be giving a presentation. That's on February the 18th. Dr. Craig Braun, who's an ophthalmologist, will be talking on some innovative work he's doing with a nutritional supplement. Dr. Vega, medical doctor, who's an authority on essential oils. Carl Robinson, who is a respected homeopath who has taught me much of what I know about homeopathy. Dr. Frank Schallenberger, or here, Dr. John Trowbridge, will be talking about detox. Charles McWilliams, who's considered the father of microcurrent therapy, will be talking. Dr. Frank Schallenberger, who's the current editor of Second Opinion, is going to be talking about ozone. And yours truly will finish up the event. Now, many of you are new to my work, and I'd just like to give you an outline of the best way to get oriented on some of the valuable information. Let me see if I can find, here it is. You want information on the Vision Event, go to Vision Event 2023. So if you're new to my website, if you go to healingtheeye.com, these three icons are probably the most valuable areas where you need to go.
You entered 8474.
Oh, somebody's playing around with their telephone. If you don't mind turning off your phone. This is new to the site. If you go here, this gives you a lot of valuable information. Here is you can download one of my best-selling books, The 10 Essentials.
You entered and six.
And I would highly encourage you to download this book. And this icon here is for the Vision Event. So let's, when you click this here, you can become familiar with my work, here is, you can download the book. Also, if you have trouble reading, you can also listen to a YouTube a webinar on my 10 essentials. Next, I think it's important that you find out about your condition, how alternative therapies can help your condition. So here we have a list of reversing cataracts naturally, glaucoma treatment, wet macular degeneration, dry eyes, floaters, macular puckers, things like that. Then you can also get a free consult with the office. I personally review your eye records, and then I give information to the office staff to relay to you. And then lastly,
your meeting ID is
information about the Conrad program. If you're interested in some therapies, this is a link for microcurrent to learn more about microcurrent.
Enter your participant ID followed by pound.
To learn more about homeopathy, to learn more about ozone, light therapy.
Please enter the meeting password followed by pound.
And don't forget to download my best-selling book. It's free.
You are in the meeting now. I would encourage you to sign up for the vision event.
This is an amazing bargain.
You are muted.
And I think that some of the information that we're going to share with you is going to be invaluable for you to learn more about how to restore your lost vision. All right. Well, let me just... I am going to unmute, folks, so let me stop sharing. Let me see, how do I unmute? Stop sharing here. And let's see, meeting. Okay.
The host would like you to unmute your microphone. You can press star 6 to unmute.
Okay, you can unmute yourself, and now what I'd like to do is open it up for questions.
You are muted.
Okay. Now, there's a lot of background noise, and I hope that those of you on this call will be courteous to others. So try to eliminate the background noise. And we have somebody with his hand up. I don't see a name.
That me?
That's you. Yeah. Hi.
Oh, hey, Doc. How are you?
Pretty good. Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year. I think I'm going to ask my sister if you looked at my mom's records, but I'm calling for my mother who has macular degeneration. And I wanted to find out a little more information of your programs, the different things that are possible to help her.
As I mentioned, the best place to go is healingtheeye.com. And there's an icon there if you're new to our website.
I am.
You can click the video. I gave a lecture on the treatment of macular degeneration. You can download my best-selling book, and all of that will be a good start for you.
Yeah, we bought the book. My sister read it, but I haven't had a chance to read it yet.
But basically,
we have the hard copy.
My approach to the treatment of macular degeneration, and for that matter, all other eye disorders, it's kind of the same format. You know, I'm a big advocate of good nutrition. I think food is our best medicine. And a lot of times by cleaning up your diet, that can be beneficial. Proper hydration is important to help detoxify the body and reducing stress. Those are the three big things. But in particular, my interest is trying to find out the underlying cause of these various diseases. So with macular degeneration, we want to investigate, is it a circulatory problem? Is it heavy metal toxicity? Is it, a vitamin deficiency, related to diabetes, et cetera? So not only do we look for the underlying cause that's contributing to the disease, but then we're also then going to be using different treatment modalities to kind of reverse the disease. And I always like to use the alternative therapies first before you go into the, you know, the medical and surgical. And one of the most effective treatments that I've had is the microcurrent stimulation. This is a low-level electrical current which improves the circulation, helps detoxify the body, helps stimulate stem cells to rejuvenate the eye. And all these things can be very valuable. Also, I use light therapy and homeopathy. Homeopathy is a treatment approach that we believe that the body has the ability to heal itself. And with certain homeopathic remedies, we try to stimulate the body's own regenerative processes. Now, a lot of people, one of the questions they have is, well, what evidence do you have for these therapies? So let me go back here. I'm going to go back to screen share. All right. And if you go to my website, see if I'm going right here. This is it, healing the eye. Right here, peer review studies published by Dr. Chandra. So if you click here, I'm a major co-author in a book on alternative treatments. You can download my chapter here. Click here to view the outcome studies of the Chandrat program. And this article here reviews different disease categories. Like, for example, dry macular degeneration. My study dealt with 70 patients, 140 eyes. Then you can look at the results. Excuse me, I'm losing my voice. You can also go down to glaucoma, retinitis pigmentosa, various diseases. So all of that information is on the website. And as I mentioned, let's see if we can get back to where... So just type in healingtheeye.com, this area right here. And also for you in particular, go to Nudita's site. And here is a lecture I gave on the treatment of macular degeneration. And you can get more information here on microcurrent, homeopathy, ozone, light therapy.
Doc, is this this microcurrent, that's something that you have something you could sell us so that we could do at home? Because obviously we're in New Jersey.
Well, initially with my program, we actually had patients come to the office and they had microcurrent over a week treatment. And then
yeah,
they went home.
That's hard to do. Yeah.
But now, you know, with COVID, we've kind of changed our whole approach. We have a home program.
Oh, good. You
know, now with the internet and Zoom, what we do is I will review your records, your mom's records, and kind of customize a microcurrent program specifically for her. I'll send my customization protocol to the manufacturer. They'll put everything together and then they'll send her a customized machine for treatment. And okay. Then what we do is we do have, good support. We have a couple educational videos that'll show you exactly how to use the microcurrent machine along with the light therapy and everything else. That's part of our home program, which has become very, very popular.
So that'll be through YouTube or an app or something like that? The videos?
Excuse me?
The videos will be through YouTube or an app or right on
your website? They're available on YouTube.
Okay.
And let me show you that. I'm going back and forth here with my screen sharing that I think this is important information. I'll have screen share.
What did we do before YouTube?
That's a good point. Okay, here, I'm going to go, if you go to Chandrat youtube.com and go to playlists here. So go to chondra.youtube.com, go to playlists. So here we have a playlist for everybody that's involved with the Chondrite program. Here it is, the full list of videos. So,
and welcome everyone. My name is Dr. Edward Chondrite, for those of you that don't know me.
So we have an intro video, but let me go through some of the videos here. So this is a review of the InspireStar microcurrent machine right here. We have a talk on improving the results of microcurrent because, you know, reversing vision loss is more than just putting microcurrent and doing a treatment. We talk to you about diet, nutrition, other things you need to do. We also do a six-hour urine test and test for heavy metals. And these are all part of the home program. I talk about taking your homeopathic remedy, light therapy. So all these are key videos to help you really get started with the home program. And all of these videos are based on lectures that I gave when I actually had patients in our Florida office. So at one time we had people come, 10 to 12 people that stay with us for a week, and they would go through all the treatments and training. So now, like you said, what would we do before YouTube? So now we have all these lectures online available for you, so you can follow through.
Right. I have a
Dr. Chondrite, I have a question.
Okay, let me try to get, I'm going to stop sharing so I can see everybody here.
Ellen?
Ellen.
Over here? Oh, yeah.
We have two Ellens.
Yeah, you do. It's weird.
Hey, Ellen.
Nice.
How about Ellen Good first? Because I see your last name there.
Okay, yeah, that's me. So I have a few questions, but primarily, I have glaucoma. I've had it since I was 36. I have some partial vision loss in my right eye now. Obviously I'm 54 now, but you, when you talk about microcurrent and programming the machine and, you know, and I'm wondering, I mean, I know we're here that myelination tissue doesn't regenerate for nerves. So I'm just kind of wanting to understand, you know, what the process of restoring glaucoma vision loss. I mean, I know you're saying, so I get that. And then I also, it looks like you have location. So the microcurrent and the programming and all that, but also it looks like you have Florida and Arizona. So I was trying to.
Oh, no. I'm no longer seeing patients in person.
Okay.
Because of, COVID and, you know, it was a big change in my practice because before I would insist that patients come to see me. Now, over the 2 years of COVID, we had the home program. I review records. I usually work with your eye doctor if he's interested. So you'll do follow-up pressures and things like that with your local eye doctor and you'll share the records with me. But we will be doing like a personal 101 on Zoom. I'll get to know a little bit more about you, the extent of your glaucoma damage. I would encourage you to listen to my YouTube presentation called The Big Lie About Glaucoma. And I don't know if you listen to it, but the big lie is that glaucoma is more than pressure. It's health of the optic nerve. Most eye doctors don't do anything to try to help the optic nerve. They just lower the pressure, more drops, more surgery. My approach is, yeah, the pressure is important, but we got to do everything we can to help regenerate that optic nerve. Proper diet, nutrition, hydration, reducing stress, and doing treatments like microcurrent. And I don't know if I have access, but I have dramatic results of patients that have had improvements of their visual field after a month of treatment. So I don't believe when eye doctors tell you the optic nerve can't be regenerated. We can restore lost vision. And I would encourage you to look at my study that was published on glaucoma patients and a large percentage of them, now not everybody, it all depends on how much damage you have and also depends on your underlying cause. I mean, you're a young woman, but if you're 90 years old and you have diabetes and you're overweight and you have a lot of medical problems, the prognosis is just not as good. But if you have a healthy underlying system, there's a really good chance that we can work on, restoring some of that lost vision, and more importantly, preventing future progression.
Do you use ozone with glaucoma?
Ozone therapy, unfortunately, is something that is a little bit more complicated, and many of my patients use ozone.
I use ozone. I have a generator.
Okay, good. So and there's two ways of doing that, either auricular in your ears or rectal. And actually, Dr. Frank Schallenberger is going to be one of the speakers at the Vision event, and he's kind of like the father of ozone therapy. Now, there's something in the chat here about microcurrent. Are there any side effects of microcurrent? Well, we use an extremely low current. The current that we use is a microamp, and it is a millionth of an amp, and there is no pain or sensation during the delivery of the microcurrent. And some of you may have had acupuncture treatments and using a TENS device. They use a very, very high current, which does cause some pain and discomfort. And then also I'm working with some researchers that have actually identified certain frequencies that we use. And these frequencies have been shown to stimulate stem cells, rejuvenation. So there is a lot of science out there that show that these frequencies that we're using in the low level current, and the key is low level, can help regenerate. So the other, Ellen, I think you're muted. You have to unmute yourself.
Yes, okay. I have a couple of questions and I wanna just say what they are first and then you can address whichever makes sense. First of all, I am wondering about what the diet is, if it's like whole food, plant-based, low carb or Mediterranean or what, that's one question. The other one is if you do find that the source, I have macular degeneration at the moment, it's still dry. But if you find out that heavy metals are the cause behind the illness, what do you do? What is the patient at home, since it's a home therapy, you can't really do chelation, but what would you recommend or how do you approach that? And then the last one is there's one doctor I've been looking at who uses a hyperbaric chamber. Uh-huh. Do you know anything about that? Anyway,
a lot of good questions.
How do you deal with heavy metals?
Diet tends to be specific to the person. But I'm a big advocate of a raw food, plant-based diet, avoiding genetically modified food, avoiding cooked preserved food. Colorful food will give you colorful vision. So my approach is, and the first chapter in my book, The 10 Essentials to Save Your Sight, goes into that in much more detail.
Okay, I'll look at that book then.
Yeah, I think 80% of our diet should be
mostly raw. And how about if heavy metals are the cause?
Well, we do have a method. First of all, it's important to identify what metals are the problem.
Okay.
And then we do have a rectal suppositories that you can use at home, and also an ocular detox formula called Ocular Detox.
Oh, fantastic. So part of the testing that you would do would be for heavy metals.
Yeah, we do a six-hour urine test. And I think the six-hour urine test is probably the most effective way of really evaluating heavy metals. I don't believe in hair analysis or just the spot urine or blood test. When these heavy metals get into your body, they go into your bone, your brain, your fat.
Right. And you may not see it in just a regular urinalysis.
In fact, you could be dying. You could be dying of lead poisoning and your urine and blood will be normal because it goes into your brain. You need to somehow do a challenge test. And that's the way most doctors do that.
Uh-huh. That's what I thought. Okay. Yeah. And then what about this hyperbaric chamber where they have, you know, like, well,
the hyperbaric is really not part
of
the
program. I'm not going to
But the hyperbaric can be an effective treatment because anything that we can increase the oxygenation in your eye is going to be beneficial. But see, my program is based on, I want to empower you as a patient to be able to do things at home.
Right. So we're not dependent on.
Like, for example, acupuncture works, but you got to be going to a doctor's office a couple times a week. And, you know, the same thing with IV chelation. You got to go to a doctor's office. So
right.
I'm not saying that the home program is going to take care of everybody. Some people do need to go and get IV chelation.
But you would know that from the testing and everything. You would help the patient figure that out.
We like to start out with the home program and see how you respond. And then we may add some other modalities depend on your response.
Awesome.
Try to empower you. That's why when you invest in buying the microcurrent machine, it's yours. You have a program for your eye, and also there are 10 spots on the machine. You have 10 additional programs, so you can do something for headaches. You can do something for arthritis, inflammation. So it becomes almost like a home-based aid to help you with other problems too.
And one other thing before I go, thank you. These answers are so good. Thank you. If you have digestive issues, like let's say you have histamine problems or you have a weak digestive system and you can't really digest raw foods very well or fiber, you know, do you address any of that as part of what you're working with?
Yeah, that would be, would want to look at the underlying cause, why you have a gut problem, and then homeopathy and some other treatments may address that.
I see. Thank you. Thank you so much.
So is it Dejana?
It's Diana.
Diana, okay.
I wanted to ask you, I live in Germany and I had 2 months ago, I developed cataract and I had a surgery 2 months ago. But now, first after that, I got dry eyes. My eyes were very dry. And last week I got blepharitis, like inflammation of eyelids. And like precaution, they gave me azithromycin, that's antibiotic. Although they said I can try without any kind of antibiotic, but like precaution, because I had a surgery, that I can maybe try to see, can I, I'm just now thinking, should I give a chance not to use antibiotic? Or is it any homeopathic?
You know what? I can't answer that question. I can't give you medical advice because you're in Germany and I'm here in the US. Now, I would be happy to review your records. Now, first of all, I never give specific advice unless I review your eye records. And so if you send your records by email to the office, I'd be happy to review them at no charge. There are some alternative methods. In fact, ozone eye drops can be a substitute for antibiotics.
Yes, as soon as I finish, leave it in there. You can turn it off, but leave it in there.
But send the records to the office so I could review it, okay?
Okay,
thank you. And we have a couple other questions here. Sun Moon, I don't see you, but your hand is up.
Hello, doctor. This is Sun Moon.
Can you mute everybody? There's a lot of static and noise.
Doctor, can you hear me?
Yes, I hear you.
Okay, I have grade 2 cataracts. And I had sent my records to you by email, and Chris from your office did get back to me. I got the Oclumet. I live in the Caribbean and I had to ship in the Oclumet.
In the Caribbean?
Yeah, I live in the Caribbean, yeah. I live in paradise. I live in paradise.
Okay, we're going to all come down and visit you in the winter time, okay?
Yes, of course. Actually, this is winter for us now. It's too cold. We have a cold front today. And we don't have to wear anything for the cold front, though. I mean, we don't have to wear this weather. But yes, you're almost welcome to visit me. So I have grade 2 cataracts in both my eyes. My right eye is a lazy eye that has cataract 2. My only good eye is the left eye, which has also cataract, and both are like grade 2. And you did come back and say it is possible, and you gave 3 different options. I got the Oclumet, but like first 2 days I put it, it made my eyes more blurry. But just to get the benefit, I tried putting it twice a day for 3 more days, and my eyes became like very red. Then I called the college pharmacy people. I spoke to the pharmacist, and they said if it's reacting, if it was him, he would have stopped using it. So I stopped using it. And then I realized that I have very dry eyes too. And I used to use Systane before, but I had stopped using it for a little bit of time. And then in August, I used it again, but it made my eyes blurry for a very long time. Like a week, my eyes were blurry after using Systane. So I don't use it anymore. Now I have dry eyes. I don't know what to do because any drops that I'm using, I'm getting blurry eyes. I even used Cinerara Maritima, the homeopathy one. It, like even just one drop in the eye, it made my eyes blurry for the
Let me just make a comment because it sounds like you have a lot of sensitivities to different eye drops. I would highly recommend a homeopathic consult because there has to be an underlying problem with your body if you're so sensitive to eye drops. So homeopathy treats that underlying problem. And, you know, we may want to consider other treatments. I mentioned earlier, if you really want to treat a disease, you have to look at the underlying problem. I'm assuming that you have good nutrition. Mm-hmm. But one of the biggest reasons why people get cataracts is poor nutrition. When I do mission eye surgery in Africa and Central America, I see people in their 20s and 30s with advanced cataracts because they have poor nutrition. So nutrition is important. Also addressing heavy metals. There have been numerous studies that show that elevated lead leads to the development of a cataract. So we need to find the underlying cause. And if your lead is elevated, you may want to begin some type of a chelation program.
Okay, I did do it before I even got to know you, like a year ago, I did do a homeopathy consultation with I'm from India. Basically, I live in Caribbean for the last 3 decades. But I did a consult with a homeopathy doctor from back home in India. And she did give me some medicines. Like in the morning, she told me to take Pulsatilla and in the afternoon, Carbo-Veg because I have gas. And the night, she told me Nux Vomica. The thing is, when I get the globules.
Well, let me just make a comment. You're telling me that with this homeopathic, it doesn't sound like they're really treating your constitution. She gave you various homeopathic remedies. Mm-hmm. You need to have a constitutional treatment to treat your underlying problem. The biggest mistake a lot of homeopathic doctors do, and it really angers me, you go to a homeopathic doctor and they give you 5 different medicines. Take this for your gas, take this for your headache. That is not homeopathy.
Okay.
Homeopathy, we believe that there's one problem with your body. So when I talk to somebody and they have various complaints, there's one homeopathic remedy to treat those, not 5 or 6. Many doctors use homeopathy just like the allopathic or Western doctor. You know, you take this medicine for your headache, take this for your high blood pressure, you end up with a shopping bag full of medicines. That's not homeopathy.
Okay,
we got to take some other questions here.
Okay. I have just one more question.
Futterman, is that your name? ENID.
Yes, ENID. Hi, thank you. I have a pretty bad cataract in my left eye, and I recently became aware of Sally Norton's work on oxalate poisoning. She just published a book. I think it's the only book about oxalate toxicity, poisoning. And it was rather eye-opening. It's very, very well.
So you have a question, or you're giving me some advice on oxalates?
I'm asking you what you think about that and whether you've investigated that, because cataracts are on her list of common ailments that occur.
Well, first of all, there are many, many causes for cataracts.
Yes, she actually says that.
Many causes. I'm a belief that cataracts may be a form of focal scurvy, vitamin C deficiency. You don't see full-blown scurvy. Scurvy is when your teeth fall out, your skin falls apart. That's scurvy. But focal scurvy, there's a brilliant doctor, Dr. Levy. He's a medical doctor and also an attorney, wrote a book on this, where I think, and also clinically, when you do develop a cataract, the ascorbic acid levels or glutathione levels are decreased in the aqueous that bathes the eye, the cataract. So we have to look at vitamin C and glutathione levels. That's part of the problem. Now you can talk about, there are many toxins that can cause cataracts. There's probably I could give you a list of 1,000 things that can cause cataracts in terms of toxins. So sure, oxalates are one of them.
Well,
in my experience, it's usually elevated lead, nutritional problems, etc.
Understood. It's just that I was very compelled by this book because that cataracts are not the only health issue that I have, and many of them are on the list. And I started eating a low oxalate diet, and I'm feeling a lot better. So it doesn't mean that the cataracts are necessarily that. I was just curious about your experience or your knowledge of this issue, which seems to be coming.
You know, as I mentioned, there are many, many toxins that could cause it or metabolic problems.
I
did my training. There's different deficiencies that can cause cataracts, and I'm sure oxalate could be one of them. And it may be specific for you, but it's not a run-of-the-mill treatment for everybody.
That's why
I kind of take an individual approach and look at each person to see what is the possible cause of not only their cataract, but their macular degeneration, glaucoma, et cetera.
Understood. Is there, can you just give us an idea of the price of the home program? Or does it vary, or how does that work?
The price, it's roughly around $5,000. And that includes the microcurrent machine, which itself is $3,000. It includes light therapy, your initial kickstart with homeopathic remedies, nutrition, et cetera. Two consultations with me. I have group meetings twice a month with all my patients. So it includes a lot. If you want to get more information on that, I think you can go to the Kondrat Home Program. There's a link. If you go to my, and it goes through all the details about the home program.
Thank you.
But the first step is for me to review your medical records. And we see if you're a good candidate for the program. Just the other day, I talked with a patient and he wasn't a good candidate for the program. His cataracts were too advanced. And I didn't want to mislead him to think that the program could reverse those cataracts. You know, I wear two hats. I'm a board certified eye surgeon and I've done thousands of cataract operations. But I also wear that alternative medicine cap. And I believe that the first approach to any disease should be looking at the underlying cause. You shouldn't just jump in and have the surgery. In some situations you need that surgical option. But on the other hand, you got to look at why. You know, the cataracts, I think, can be just the tip of the iceberg. You have to look at what is really going on underneath. Yeah, you may take care of the cataracts, and a couple months later, a couple years later, you get macular degeneration. You're getting some other eye problem, or you're getting glaucoma. And we see that all the time. We got to treat the underlying problem.
I completely agree with you.
Good. Good. Well, thank you so much. Good questions.
Thank you.
All right. We have a lot of questions in the chat, and I'm sorry that I can't get to them. Let me see here. A lot of people are commenting on other treatment modalities. And to be honest with you, over the last 40 years, I've investigated, you name it. And, you know, some of these treatments that people are popping up in the chat are just garbage. Other ones may work a little bit. And over the last years, I've kind of been geared towards the modalities that I feel work the best. My goal is to turn around your vision problem. And if we're successful, you should notice a change within a couple weeks to a month. It's not the type of program where you got to do for 5 years and then let me know if it's helping. So that's been the success of my program. Usually, if you're going to benefit, you're going to have some type of change within the first couple of weeks to a month. Now, what do I mean by change? I don't mean complete reversal of your vision problem. Usually we like to see a shift in your energy, your mental, emotional state, you know, a shift in your general health, along with some improvement of your vision. That's the goal. So we know we're on the right track, and then you'll continue the program. And if you do go to my website and look at my published study, all of those results were published based on 1 week of treatment. We, you know, carefully measured a patient's different parameters, their visual fields, their acuity, their contrast, and then we repeated those tests after 1 week. That's the kind of changes. Also, there have been a lot of questions on cataracts. Out of all the conditions I treat, cataracts are the most difficult, and I'm being honest with you, because usually cataracts, you got to look at the underlying problem. So it's not like a quick fix. Many people think, I'll just take a couple of eye drops and it'll reverse it, and I'll be back to normal. No, it requires some work. We got to identify, do you have heavy metal poisoning? Do we got to begin treatment on that. We got to look at your diet and nutrition. We got to look at underlying problems before we can have success with cataracts. Let me see.
Ken, can you mute yourself, please, Ken?
All right. Thanks for being the mute watchdog.
Well, it's just that we can't hear you. That's the problem. I know. Yeah.
That's the problem when we have these large meetings. And a lot of times if you call in on a telephone, it's impossible to mute the phone. We can mute the computer board here. Valerie Chapman. Valerie, you got your hand up.
Okay.
Hi, Valerie. I can hear you, but I can't see you. You got to adjust your screen.
Okay. Can you see me now?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm logged in for both of my parents, my dad in Germany, and he has glaucoma, and my mother, she's on here too in St. Louis. The question that I have for you is, when you're measuring their progress, are they going to their current ophthalmologist to have that, you know, that progress measured, or how is that done?
Okay, well, there's a couple ways we measure progress. One is subjective, mm-hmm. how you're doing. I mean, with glaucoma, you may have loss of your peripheral vision or sensitivity to light. We want to see improvement of that. And also, I do require that you go back, that you do maintain care with your current eye doctor. And so I want you to send me records from every eye visit. So, you know, glaucoma is a serious disease. And I never recommend patients to stop their eye drops and, you know, I'm going to cure their glaucoma. My goal is to let's begin do things to address the health of the optic nerve. And please watch the my presentation on the big lie about glaucoma. Mm-hmm. There's so many things we can do to help improve the health of the optic nerve. And so then patients will be better able to tolerate their eye pressure compared to they don't do anything. I mean, simple exercise, meditation, stress reduction, proper hydration, changing your diet, they're beneficial, along with light therapy. Mm-hmm. Now, it's interesting, light therapy, I'm sure if you would ask your doctor, doctor, can light therapy help my glaucoma? He'll probably laugh at you. But in 1950, in the American Journal of Ophthalmology, there were two articles published that definitively showed that certain wavelengths of light, certain colors, can lower and help treat glaucoma. And this is one of our most prestigious journals, but doctors tend to ignore it. You know, the medical profession is run by big pharma, and it's really a shame. It's a crime. You know, these drugs are coming out on the market that are extremely toxic. I've seen so many glaucoma patients that are suffering. Their eyes are red, the drops burn, and, you know, the eye drops are worse than them actually losing vision.
Yeah, it is.
So, you know, the goal is let's get your body healthy, and then we can gradually reduce the eye drops or maybe eliminate some of the eye drops. That needs to be a, you know, a big approach with glaucoma.
Thank you.
Thank you, and good luck, and good luck with your parents.
Yes, definitely. I'll be sending in their information.
But the first step is let me review their records to see if they're a good candidate for the program.
Okay, will do.
Sun Moon, you have your hand up, but I can't see you.
Yes, my video is off.
Okay, I hear you.
Okay, so I have a question about the color therapy, not light therapy, color therapy. Not even the color therapy. The putting the computer monitor on night mode all day. I work like 6 to 7 hours on the computer. Is it okay to leave it on night mode the whole time? Because it gives a little yellow light.
No, if you go to Kondrat podcast, I interviewed a brilliant researcher, Abraham Hayim, who's done a lot of work on light toxicity. And there's a good podcast on that. We need blue light during the day. That's why God made the sky blue, the ocean blue. We need blue light during the day. Blue light at night is very toxic to the eye. So a lot of computers and even the iPhone now has a night shift, which goes more towards the red spectrum. So if you're doing a lot of computer work at night, I would highly recommend that you use the blue blocker. What's a blue blocker? Blue blocker is a filter that blocks the blue light. They're also called shooter glasses. You can get them at drugstores and optical shops that block the blue light. I recommend that at night, but we need blue light during the day.
Okay, so leaving it on could also dilate the pupil. The leaving the night light on could cause harm to the eyes?
Well, it all depends on your nature and your constitution. You know, many people will use a computer and ignore safety features and they don't develop any eye problem. But if your constitution's weak, maybe you have nutritional deficiency and other issues, it could cause damage to you. But my recommendation is, in the ideal world, if you really want to have a healthy body, when the sun sets, you should rest and sleep. When the sun comes up, where our bodies are designed to work on a circadian rhythm. When you interfere with that circadian rhythm, you are going to trigger health issues. So if you are going to be using your computer at night, limit the computer use and use a blue blocker. That's my advice.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, thank you. Ken, is that your hand up? All right, no, you're. Other questions? Sidel, is that how you pronounce it?
Uh-huh. Sidel.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Hi. For a posterior vitreous detachment, is one of the modalities better than another, ozone microcurrent?
That's a mouthful, posterior vitreous detachment. Now, unfortunately, as we get older, everybody will get a posterior vitreous detachment. It's a part of aging. And for those of you that never heard that term before, the eye is filled with jelly. As we get older, it shrinks. The general rule, you take your age, and that's the percent chance you'll get a posterior vitreous detachment. So if you live to be 100, there's 100% chance you'll get a posterior vitreous detachment. By itself, the posterior vitreous detachment doesn't cause any major big issues. Sometimes it can cause floaters, big floaters. It can also maybe tear the retina or even cause a hemorrhage. So generally speaking, we don't treat posterior vitreous detachments, but we do treat the side effects of the detachment.
Well, what if it's beginning to tear? I mean, it either tears or it doesn't tear.
Well, typically when it separates, it may cause a small tear. That in itself may not need any treatment. Usually the tears are self-healing. Sometimes a medical doctor will have to do a laser treatment or freeze it to prevent it from progressing. I'd be happy to take a look at your eye records to see, you know, what's going on and give you, you know, my advice.
I was just thinking that one of the modalities would heal it, you know, so it goes away.
Well, it's not going to go away, unfortunately. Once it separates from the back of the eye, we can't reattach it. But we can treat some of the symptoms which may occur. Like, for example, a lot of floaters or flashes and things like that.
Yeah, that's the diagnosis, posterior vitreous detachment.
But are you having symptoms with that?
Well, yeah, I mean, the float, you know, there's floaters get darker, you know. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, I'm used to really good vision my whole life. So I don't want it to get any worse. I don't want it to detach.
Well, what I tell patients with any eye problem, especially the beginning of the eye problem, you got to look at the basics. Look at your diet, clean up your diet. If you do have heavy metal toxicity, you got to treat those heavy metals because that could be contributing to the problems in your eye.
Yeah.
Proper hydration, reducing stress, all these things.
Yeah. It's been 2 or 3 years, so it's not getting any better. It's not getting any worse. But I thought maybe if I went through the vision program, then I might be able to eliminate it. And
well, the microcurrent, I've had many patients, the microcurrent has reduced some of the symptoms of the floaters and helped stabilize it. Mm-hmm. But we're not able to reverse the detachment.
I have one other question. So you can figure out somebody's homeopathic remedy in the at-home program without personally meeting with them?
Oh, no, we have a extended consultation, a Zoom consultation. I'll be asking you a lot of questions.
Okay.
You know, I review your records. I look at, you know, homeopathy, we don't just treat the disease, we treat the person.
Yeah.
So I look at what the basic homeopathic doctor does. We look at your mental, emotional state, causative factors, stress, what makes you happy, what makes you sad, are you hot, are you cold, what kind of food you like, etc. Other medical problems you have, issues, traumas. We put everything together. And my expertise is, because I'm an ophthalmologist, I'll look at your particular eye problems and how they fit in, you know, with your constitutional remedy.
And if you have a homeopathic remedy that was assigned to you many years ago, like 10 or 15 years ago, it's not necessarily the same remedy today.
No, the homeopathic remedies can change.
Okay.
It can change. And of course, you know, the homeopathic remedy that you took years ago may be the right remedy for you now. But, you know, it can change based on your symptoms and, you know, changes in your physical body.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you. Good questions. So those of you that might be interested in the program, the first step would be for me to, you know, take a look at your records to see if you're a candidate. And I can personally talk to you after I review the records, but I do look at all the I records and I make my assessment and make some recommendations, and the office staff will get back to you as to those recommendations. Some things that I recommend for all of you is, you know, getting tested for heavy metals. I'm a big believer in, you know, treating the underlying cause. And if you do have metal toxicity, you got to treat that. Also look at your diet and nutrition. You know, I think that the biggest problem with our health is our nutrition. And reducing stress. That's a big factor. And unfortunately, many of my colleagues in ophthalmology caused patients to have a lot of stress. If you don't have surgery, you're going to go blind. If you don't take these eye drops, I don't want you as a patient. I mean, my goodness, then that causes stress. So I think there has to be a partnership with the doctor and the patient. That's what I believe in. And, you know, I want to work with you to try to find out what steps you need to take to really conquer your vision problem. And I would highly encourage all of you to sign up for the vision event. We have a phenomenal lineup of speakers. In fact, some of these speakers are people that I respect and that have taught me over the years. And you'll not only be able to hear them give their presentation, but also ask them questions. Gianna, do you have another question?
Basically, yes, because what you said now, is it normal procedure, because it's recommended for everyone to go after cataract surgery for the polishing of the lenses with the YAG laser?
Not everyone. You know, okay. The general rule is the younger you are, the greater the chance of the polishing. Because the younger you are, the body stimulates the healing and scarring. There tends to be a greater need for polishing in younger people. So if you're 80 or 90 and you have surgery, chances of polishing are very, very slim.
Thank you.
Okay, any other questions? We're coming to a close. We're gonna be having these meetings periodically because I really enjoy meeting all of you and trying to help you any way I can, you know, with your eye problems. I have a lot of material that's available for you, you know, free. Please, if you haven't read my book, download it. It's free. It's my gift to you. The first chapter, in fact, one third of the book is on nutrition. I feel that that is essential in terms of helping restore our health and well-being and our vision. I have a lot of really good lecture that I've given on different eye problems. If you have cataracts, I have a good summary of, you know, how to treat cataracts, glaucoma, macular degeneration, etc. And sign up for the vision event. I think it's a great opportunity to really expand your knowledge on treatments that I think are really going to be beneficial for you. And remember, my goal is to help empower you to learn what you need to do and to become actually independent of doctors. Once you know what's your underlying cause, you can do these treatments, you know, on your own. So I want to thank everybody for joining me. Blessings to you all. And I look forward to working with you to help you conquer your vision loss.